come I see haters. Come with me as we explore the Sonoran Desert like you've never seen it before. Come on. One of the first things you will see in the desert is a green tree. This is the Palo Verde tree, Verde meaning green. It is the state tree of Arizona, and you will find this tree all over the place in the Sonoran Desert. Barrel cactus. This is a very large barrel cactus. They can grow quite large, and they have a hook type barb. You can actually use it as a fishing hook. This one is not bent as usually they are, but you can use it as a fishing hook. And then every year they seed. These are hard to get off. But in here is the seeds to the barrel cactus. And usually birds eat these, break it open, and take the seeds, and they will be all over the desert. And that is how the barrel cactus multiplies. A larger saguaro cactus can weigh up to 1,000-1,500 pounds. If this cactus fell on you, it would kill you instantly. It can hold 1,000 pounds of water. So if you're ever in the need to drink water in the desert, if you're lost, you can always punch a hole in this cactus with a rock and get some sticks and dig out and get some nourishment. As you can see, the needles on that one are also very pointy. One thing you will need in the desert is a walking stick, and I will explain later. This is a dead saguaro cactus. When it dies, the insides are made up of these long stick-like poles. Now, what you do is you pull one off, and now I have my walking stick. Now, why do you need this walking stick, you may ask? If you're walking down the desert and a rattlesnake is in front of you or jumps out, you use the stick to hit in front of him so he bites the stick instead of your leg. You also can use it as a weapon in case you're attacked by, say, a bobcat, coyote, javelina. You can beat him, hit him in the face. You never walk through the desert without a walking stick. It also helps you climb mountains. Here in the desert, you should always be prepared. You should have at least 3 bottles of water for every 4 hours of hiking. You should always have your walking stick, your hat. Without your hat, the sun will beat down and fry your head. You should drink every 15 minutes and carry some food with you and eat a little bit as you go. You don't need a lot. That will keep you alive in the desert. You should also have a little 4 or 6-in-1 tool with pliers, a knife, and so on. The pliers are for pulling spines out of it, or cactus. The knife is for cutting into a cactus if you have to get nutrients if you're lost in the desert. And if you have it, you should always have your cell phone with you. That's your last resort, or your first resort, whatever, however you want to look at it. The point is, be prepared. because the desert is harsh and only the strong can survive. Also, make sure you've got your walking stick. Let us continue. As I'm walking through this wash, I come across a large wall, which is actually the desert floor, which is a good example to show you what the desert floor is made out of. It is basically made out of clay, rock, and stone. And this is hard as concrete. This is why it is very hard to plant stuff in the desert, because it is hard as rock. Also, animals make little holes in these cliffs. As you can see up there, there is a hole. It looks like it might be a pack rat hole. I see a cactus, a jumping cactus spine up there, so he might be in there. But we'll find a better one. So as you can see, this is what the desert floor is actually made out of. Stone, clay, small rocks. It is hard as concrete. Which is why when it rains, the water beads off the top of the ground and gets down into these washes and creates little rivers. Okay, we're in luck. I found a pack rat nest. This is his entrance, and you can see he dragged the jumping cactus, or choya, to the front of his nest to keep predators out. He also put them on top. He's basically under this fallen cactus, and he just dug whatever he can dig, because you really can't dig into the desert too much. So that is a pack rat hole. They're usually by trees or bushes. And this is where he drug the choya. I'll give him some extra ones. And he drags them over. So that is where you will find your pack rat. Alright, I'm heading back. I found a little shade here on the side of this wash, this cliff here. Whenever you see some shade, get in there and cool down, because you're not going to find too much shade out in the desert. So take about 15 minutes, drink some water, and cool down, and then you're ready to go. This is Icy Haters, and this is the Sonoran Desert. Catch you next time.